Good day. Today we're going to get creative and have some fun. You see, in this last video, I was happy to let you know about the new receiver protocols the multi-protocol module devs have given us to use with the Jumper T16. Today, I'm happy to let you know Betaflight 4.2 is due out shortly, and the Betaflight devs have given us new features to go along with it. I, for one, am very grateful to them and all of our open source developers. If you'd like to show your support for the Betaflight, OpenTX, or the multi-protocol module development teams, I've got links in the video descriptions of all of my videos you can click on at any time to do so. And if you'd like to support your TMacFPV channel, I've got a Patreon link below, as well as affiliate links for your convenience you can use to purchase any of your FPV gear at no additional cost to you. So the new features of Betaflight 4.2 can be found at this site, which I'll link below. However, today I'm going to show you one of its fun little secret features not currently mentioned in those notes. It's your own personalized Betaflight OSD custom logo, which you can program to appear in your OSD when you arm your quad. That's where you can get creative and strut your stuff. Today, I'll show you how you can make your own Betaflight OSD custom logo and use it prior to the Betaflight 4.2 release when you power up your quad. Then, for the new feature that works with arming, I'll show you how to update your quad to Betaflight 4.2, install your personal custom logo, and strut your stuff on your goggles DVR videos. Now for more fun! I know you can do a better job of designing your own custom OSD logo than I do in this video, so I'm going to give you the chance to show me and the world what you can come up with. After you follow the steps in this video, save a screenshot from your goggles DVR showing your custom logo and either send it to me through email or through Facebook or Instagram message by Sunday, May 17th. My contact information is below. If I get more than one submission, I'll narrow them down to the top two or three, then post those in my YouTube community tab with a poll for folks to vote on for their favorite logo. I may do the same poll in the Fast Track FPV Facebook page, as well as Instagram and Facebook stories, so keep an eye out for those as well. Voting will last 1 week, so make sure to get all of your friends to vote for yours. Whichever OSD custom logo gets the most votes, I'll give a shout out to in the video I post on May 29th, and the top logo winner will get a free TMac Diamondback Rattler frame kit, which you can check out in a link below. This is open to both U.S. and international viewers. Sound like fun? Then give this video a thumbs up below, share it with your artistically gifted friends, and subscribe to your TMac FPV channel, your home for your journey to better FPV fun, flights, and racing stuff.
All right, the first thing we're going to do is design our Betaflight OSD custom logo. And to do that, I'm using a program called Microsoft PowerPoint. I've been using it for decades, and I really like it. It's very easy to use. If you're not familiar with it and would like to check it out, I've placed links to it down in the video description below. Let me explain what I have on this sheet to begin with. First of all, what I've done is I've grabbed my lucky quadcopter image from Google Images, as well as some images of some props. This is what I started out with. I've also created various shapes in black and white just by using these shape buttons up here. So I made all these shapes for the various parts of the quadcopter. And then what I did in order to get this image in a black and white outlined image is I used a program called Paint, and we'll go to that now. And we just want to upload that image into Microsoft Paint. So we just drag and drop, and there's our image. I can close this out. I'm going to zoom in. And then to change this from the emerald green to the black outlined four-leaf clover, I just used this eraser. And you can go along in here and erase everything that you don't want. Like that. I'm just going through it quickly here to demonstrate how I went about doing it. And then once I was done with that, I clicked on File, Properties, change it to black and white, hit OK. And it says once you do this, you can't undo it. Click OK. And then you've got a black outlined four-leaf clover. Go ahead and save that to a folder that you've created on your hard drive. And now I've got a black and white four-leaf clover I can use for my Betaflight OSD custom logo, which is what we have here. So that's how we went from this image to this image. Now all we have to do is assemble the parts. So we assemble the parts. We group it. Get rid of this. Add some text. We want the inside of the letters to be white and the outline to be black. So we'll change the inside to white and the outline to black. And we want to make the outline a little bit thicker. We'll make it 3. Change this to FPV. Align these two. Group all of this. Click on it, and then we save it as a picture to a folder we've made. We'll call this Betaflight OSD TMacFPV Logo. Save. And now we've got the beginnings of our Betaflight OSD custom logo. And now we're ready to finalize it for import into Betaflight. To do that, we open our Microsoft Paint program, which is the same program that we use to erase the emerald color from our four-leaf clover, and then we import our Betaflight OSD TMacFPV logo by dragging and dropping. Now, our Betaflight OSD custom logo template canvas size is limited to 288 by 72. Down here, we see our pixel size is 1694 by 605. So we need to change this canvas size to, by resize, click on pixels, maintain aspect ratio, and we're going to go 288 by 72. Now, when we change that, this 288 number goes back to 201. Don't worry about that. We'll fix that later. Just click OK, and it gets really small. So we need to zoom in so we can see what we're doing. Now, we need to change this to 288 by 72. And in order to do that, we click on the corner over here with the left mouse button depressed. We move this out to 288. 7, 8. Let go of the mouse button. All right, now our canvas is 288 by 72. We want to go back to home and I want to select. And I'm going to do a rectangular selection, and I'm going to click on that. And then I'm going to move it to the center of our canvas by pressing and holding the left mouse button. That looks about centered, enough space on that side and that side. Now what we want to do is we want to make sure that our entire image that we've imported is in black and white. Even if it doesn't appear that you have colors in your image, you'll want to make sure and do this. To do that, we go to File, Properties, click on black and white, hit OK. Now it's going to warn us once we do this, we cannot revert back to what it was originally. That's OK. And there's our black and white image that we need. Now once it's in black and white, we want this background to be green because green in the Betaflight OSD is going to show up as transparent. So in order to get this background green, we need to go back to Properties and click on Color. Click OK. Once we do that, we want to make this background green. And in order to do that, we click on Edit Colors. And on this RGB color code, we want to change 0 in green to 255. Click OK. And now we've got this green color up here. We want to click on the bucket and then move your mouse cursor to the background. Boom. Do a left mouse click. And it fills the entire background with the green color. It's looking good now. Now we can zoom back out and you get a better idea of what it might actually look like on your OSD screen. So at this point, what we want to do is save it. And I'm going to save it as Betaflight OSD TMacFPV logo, a PNG file. Click save. And now we've got our Betaflight OSD custom logo ready to be uploaded into Betaflight 4.2. All right, now that we have our custom logo created, prior to Betaflight 4.2, it will only work and we will only see it on our OSD when we first power up our quad, which for most of us means we won't actually see it in the OSD. That's why eTracer 65 has created the new feature for us where we can actually see it when we arm our quad. However, prior to Betaflight 4.2, to get this to work when you power up your quad, you go to your Betaflight Configurator, and in this case, I am using Betaflight Configurator 10.6.0 prior to Betaflight 4.2, and we go to our OSD tab. From there, we click on Font Manager, and then we've got the opportunity to upload our custom image. This is our Betaflight default image. To upload our custom image, we select Custom Image, double-click on our custom OSD logo. It checks to make sure that the size is 288 by 72, which it is, it's in green, and that it contains green, black, and white pixels, which it does. If either of one of these did not meet the requirements, then we would get a red X with red text. In order to save our custom image, it states here that we click Upload Font to persist custom logo. So let's go ahead and do that. It's uploading. And now we should be good to go with our Betaflight custom image prior to Betaflight 4.2. We'll go ahead and check it out now as we power up the quad. Okay, I'm going to power on the quad. And let's look for our custom OSD logo. Looks pretty good. All right, now what happens when I arm the quad? Nothing, because we're prior to Betaflight 4.2. Let's go ahead now and take a look at how this is going to work for Betaflight 4.2.
All right, prior to uploading our logo to Betaflight, we need to update our flight control firmware to Betaflight 4.2. Prior to doing that, we look down here and it says we need to have the latest Betaflight configurator. It's mandatory because earlier versions are not going to work properly. So the latest Betaflight configurator that will be working with Betaflight 4.2 is Betaflight configurator 10.7. Now at the time I'm making this video, it's a release candidate 1, but by the time you're viewing this video or very shortly thereafter, both the configurator 10.7 as well as Betaflight 4.2 should actually be released to the public. I'm going to go ahead and download the Betaflight configurator 10.7 release candidate 1 for the purposes of making this video. So when you go to download the regular Betaflight configurator 10.7.0 official release, you'll go to Betaflight Configurator Releases, just as I am here. And for Windows, I'm on Windows 10. I need this file, win32.exe, down here. So I'll click on that. It downloads over here. And I'll go ahead and once it's downloaded, I'll cut and paste that to a folder that I've already created previously on my computer. So I go to that folder and I paste that file. And then I go ahead and double click on this. And you see it's populating all the files underneath that folder. All right, now that it's done installing, we click Finish. Go over to my Start menu, click on Betaflight Configurator. And over here in the top left, we see that it's updated to 10.7.0, Release Candidate 1. In your case, it'll be the official release. All right, now with our quadcopter connected to our computer and its props off, we connect it to the configurator. We take a look at our target board, and we see that our board name is Omnibus F4FW. Right here by Airbot, Omnibus F4FW. So now we go update firmware, Omnibus F4FW right here. At the time I'm recording this video, Betaflight 4.2 is not officially released yet. Hopefully by the time you're viewing this video or shortly thereafter, Betaflight 4.2 will be officially released. So for now, the purposes of recording this video, I'm going to show development, and we see the latest development version 4.2 is number 2182. Dated 4/28. So I'm going to click on that. I'm going to load firmware online, and now I'm going to flash firmware. Because I received a fail notice here, I'm going to run the Impulse RC driver fixer. Driver's fixed, that's a good thing. So now we go back, and we've already loaded our firmware online, so now I'm just going to flash firmware again. Make sure it's the right one, 4.2, flash firmware. See how that Impulse RC driver fixer works like magic? It's awesome. And now we're flashing. This is the same process that you'll use with the official release of 4.2. The only difference is you do not show unstable releases, and this will not show as development, it'll show as release. And programming is successful. And that's a good thing. Now we connect, and we do want to apply custom defaults, and we come up with a warning. There's no motor output protocol selected. Accelerometer is enabled but not calibrated. Okay, so let's calibrate the accelerometer. And it flips my quadcopter up the correct way. And now we're going to go to our CLI to make sure that we've got the correct firmware for our flight controller loaded by typing in dump. Scroll to the top, and we have Omnibus F4FW, Betaflight 4.2, dated 28 April 2020, installed. And that's a good thing. Now we're ready to upload our Betaflight OSD custom logo. All right, now we connect our quad to the Configurator 10.7.0 RC1, and we go to our OSD tab. In our OSD tab, we click on Font Manager. Here's what the default image is, the Betaflight logo. And it's a reminder here that says our size must be 288 by 72, and it has to have green, black, and white pixels. So we select our custom image, which is our Betaflight OSD TMacFPV logo. We double click on that. It uploads, and it checks to make sure that it's 288 by 72, which it is. And we did a nice job centering it here. Thank you very much. And it has to contain green, black, and white pixels, which it does. And now it's uploaded. And then after we've uploaded the Betaflight OSD custom logo, in my case, TMacFPV, it says click upload font to persist custom logo. So we're going to click upload font. And we should be good to go. So let's go check it out. All right, let's see how this works with Betaflight 4.2 installed. We'll power on the quad like we did before. Looks good. Now the real test is when we arm the quad. Nice.
That's another fun feature the Betaflight devs have given us. Special thanks to eTracer65, Bruce Luckcuck, for this one. Remember to send in your custom OSD logo for a chance to win the Rattler. And check it out along with more free resources at tmacfpv.com. Thanks for your time. I'll see you next video. Clear skies, friend.